the concept of contiguous allocation. So let us see what is contiguous allocation here. Main memory usually we partition into two things now. So main memory is of two partitions now. So one is called resident operating system. The second is called as user process. A resident operating system usually held in low memory with interrupt vector. So it is in the low memory means it's in the bottom with the interrupt vector, where interrupt vector will handle this. We have studied now what is interrupt vector, interrupt source routine, all that in the unit one. So the same concept is used in resident operating system. Coming to the second partition here, user process. Here user process then held in high memory. It is held in the higher part. So user process in the user space just now what you studied. So let us see what is single partition allocation here. Single partition allocation is explained in two steps here. The relocation register scheme is used to protect user process from each other and from changing operating system code and data. So you have n number of process, right? So we have a scheme to handle this n number of process. How is that preemption and no preemption is done with between these process, and with respect to each of these process, how what is that change in the operating system code and data is required? All these things are taken care in the scheme called relocation register. So what actually the relocation register contains? It contains the value of smallest physical address, fine. So that is now mapping take place with the help of base and limit registers here. So limit register contains range of logical address. So I want to map from logical to physical address. I want to go for a concept called virtualization. How is that I will do? I will use a register called limit register, which contains the range of some logical address. Now each logical address must be less than the limit register. So the value of this logical address is always less than the limit register. That we'll see with the help of diagram here. Now, so a base and limit register define a logical address space. How is that logical address you have created now with the help of from the physical address? Yeah, how is that virtualization? Virtual address is created, is given here in the form of schematic here. So I have an operating system. I have n number of process. This is my address now, which is the physical address 25,600, 3,400, 30,400, so on. Now I will make use of base and limit register. So here base register, I have given a new value of this particular address, and I have another value for limit register. So this is how we define a logical address space with the help of base and limit registers. So same thing is given in another diagram here. Hardware address protection is done with the help of base and limit registers here. So now CPU will generate the logical address, right? So how whether whatever the logical address is generated is satisfying the requirement with respect to base and limit register is checked here. So if the address is greater than or equal to base, if yes, I'll move on to the next step. Otherwise, you are unable to continue with the execution. So trapped operating system monitor addressing error. So error is going to be generated. If the result is yes, then what? I'll check whether whatever the address is generated is less than or equal to base plus limit. If yes, that means what? Everything is fine. So the mapping of the CPU, whatever the address which is generated, the logical address is mapped to the physical address in the memory. Next we have the continuation of the contiguous allocation. How is this allocation with the OS will do now? So we go for multiple partition allocation. How is that partition take place here with respect to different process? So we have a concept called hole here. Hole is nothing but the block of available memory. So that means what? Say for example, in the first diagram you can see OS is allocating some memory space for process 5 and process 8, process 2. See the second diagram here. OS allocated process 5, some memory space is left out here. That is called hole here, which is available memory where the new process you can place it here. I have another process 2 here. Same way I have in this case, OS has allocated process 5 and process 9. I have some more memory space here. This is called hole. Then the last slot I have given for process 2. Same way, the second diagram I have large memory space. Then I have medium memory space here, and here I have low memory space. So based on this, the amount of memory space available, this memory space available in this block, which is also called as hole. So OS can decide which process I can fit for this location. So based on the length of the code of these processes, OS will decide. If I have large set of code with respect to 8, then I'll go for this. If I have some small set of code with respect to process 10, some amount of space I have allocated here. So based on that, there are so many techniques, worst fit, best fit, all that. We'll see to that later. So let us understand what is hole here. Hole is block of available memory. See here, block of available memory here, here also and here also. So holes of various sizes scattered throughout memory. See here in the first diagram, size is high. Here size is medium. Here size is low. So based on the requirement, we decide which hole I can place the requesting process here. So when a process arrives, see process 8 is going to arrive now. Fine. So it is allocated memory from a hole large enough to accommodate. So now I should think where I can allocate, whether I will allocate with the large space or medium space or whichever. So based on the length of the process 8, the code, I can OS will decide which location it can allocate with the requested process. So operating system maintains information about what? The allocated partitions. So before it is going to allocate, it should check now process 5 I have already process 5 is allocated, process 2 is allocated, right? That has to be known by OS and pre-partitions. And which is the space available now, which is the block which is free now, or you can also call it as hole. So if the OS knows the information about the hole, then only it can allocate the memory space for process. The problem is solved with these techniques. How to satisfy a request of size n from a list of free holes? I have free holes. I have more than one holes maybe. So based on the requirement, I go for a technique called first fit or best fit or worst fit. Let us see what is first fit. First fit is nothing but here OS will allocate the first hole that is big enough. Say for example, this is only one hole is shown. You assume that in the same area, I have this big hole followed by or some other space. Maybe after process to have another hole which is which has smaller area than this, so on. So now you assume that in a one schematic, I have a larger space and I have medium space and a low space here. So now first fit means what? It allocates the first hole that is big enough. Whichever is big enough, the first which we'll find, that is going to be allocated. That is called first fit. Next is best fit. What is best fit here? Allocates the smallest hole that is big enough, right? It will check for a smallest hole here. First fit means it check for a biggest hole which is at the first now, which is big enough. So here it will check for a smallest hole. So must search entire list. If that is the case, to check whether it is small, say for example, there are three holes. One is largest, one is medium, and one is low. If there are three holes, then it has to check, search all the three, right? Then only it can come to the conclusion, this is the smaller one, then I can go for it. So unless ordered by size. So because I don't know, it may not be in the same order. It is not compulsory that first there should be a large hole, then medium, then no. Maybe first I can have a small hole before this. So I should completely check process why I have, maybe after that I have some small hole, then process two I have, then another hole, then process three, four, something like that. So you need to search the entire memory space to find out the smallest hole. So next, worst fit is what? Allocate the largest hole must also search entire list. So you are going to allocate the largest here. Here best fit is smallest hole, worst fit is largest hole, whereas first fit is very first hole, whichever you find out. I'll not search here in case of first fit. Whichever I find it out first, the first hole I am going to allocate. Fine. So whereas in case of best fit, I'll go on searching all the free holes. I mean holes, the block where the memory space is available. So only after I finish searching, I'll find out which is smallest, then I'll allocate. In case of worst fit, I'll completely search. Again, I will search it. Whichever I'll find out, the OS will find out that largest one that is going to be allocated. So produces the largest leftover hole. Fine. So here first fit and best fit better than worst fit. Why? In terms of speed and storage utilization. First fit, first hole you are going to allocate, right? That means what? The process is fast here. That means what? That searching time is going to be reduced in the first fit. Yeah, whereas in case of best fit, how is that it is better? Even though I waste time in the searching, the speed will reduce, but storage utilization is high. How come? Because here, see here, largest, if you go for a, say you have a small set of code, but you are going for worst fit, if you are allocating largest space, then it's waste of memory, right? So you should avoid, you should go for a best utilization of memory means what? Whatever the space is necessary, only that much to be allocated, right? So if you go for best fit, you after you finish searching, you find the smallest hole that is going to be allocated. You are going to avoid the more memory space here. So storage utilization takes place with respect to best fit. First fit takes care of the speed and best fit takes care of the storage utilization. So better techniques are first fit and best fit compared to worst fit.